Good morning, Earthlings. Welcome to another episode. And today I am here at Purbasthali. It is one of my favorite place in the earth, and it is favorite because it is very unique place. Here you can see a lot of boats available, and you have to rent one, and you can explore this lake. And this is heaven for bird photographers. If you are into bird photography, if you are into bird study, so this is going to be heaven for you. So I just arrived at this place. Let's eat something first because I'm extremely hungry. It's early in the morning, and after eating, I talked with a boatman. He's a very young guy. I'll explore with him. So stay tuned. So here is a small shop which is extremely famous for parathas. You know, Indian parathas are very tasty and very soothing, very fulfilling. If you eat 100 grams or 200 grams, you probably don't have to eat for a few hours. That's why I'm choosing this, because it will take, I think, minimum 3 to 4 hours, and we will also take something with us because we have to eat on the boat, and that's also going to be a very unique experience. I am really excited for this one, and you will also see so many unique birds, so many migratory birds, which are frequent visitors of this place in this time. So let's eat the paratha. I have already ordered, so I just ordered this brother 100 grams of paratha, and here all the parathas he has made, and he is weighing them, and here it is. The paratha is ready, and he is giving them with this disposable plates, and it will be served with hot curry. Here the curry is kept in this bucket, and yes, this is it. Thank you. Here the paratha is ready. Here it is. Here is the paratha. It looks extremely delicious, and it is very hot. So this is what you need in this cold winter morning here. I am really excited for this soup, and here I can already see a lot of birds. There is a cattle egret that just flew by, and a lot of bee eaters. I can hear their sound, and a lot of migratory birds I can see far away. So let's finish this one, and after that we'll explore together. So here it is. Here is what I have got. It is paratha. It is petai paratha, because after preparing the paratha, they smash these parathas. This is how it looks after smashing. So I'll take it with they have prepared a curry, which is potato curry, potato, and this is cauliflower. Yeah, this is cauliflower, and let's taste how it is. Yeah, I have taken I have prepared a big bite, and yeah, it looks absolutely fantastic, and it smells delicious. Believe me, it is, you can see the smoke coming out of it, and you can see the smoke coming out of it. This is what you need at this time. Yeah. Wow. This is so soothing. I'm taking another potato with a bit of cauliflower. And here goes another bite. Wow. I am very happy today because, you know, most of the travels are solo. I travel alone, but today I am not alone. That's what I can say, and I am really happy for this. I have a cameraman with me. What more do you need? What more do you ask for? Nothing. So I am really excited for this tour. Yeah. Wow. So I just ordered to pack 300 grams of this paratha. It tastes absolutely delicious. So whenever you visit India, this is a must try. You will feel you will remember my name if you eat it. Believe me, it is so tasty, so tasty. Yeah. And so soft. So and little bit of crunchiness in some places. Let's finish this one with this big chunk. Yeah. Yeah, this is it. My plate is finished now. Good thing is that you can also get various types of sweets here. And this is winter special sweets. This is Nolil Gulay Sandesh, and this is Rasgulla, Rasogulla. Iner 6 per piece. This is 8 per piece, and this is 5 per piece. There is also cake. But we're not into sweets. I eat sweets sometimes, but I'm not right now. I'm not in the mood to eat sweets. And we'll also take a bottle of water. Yeah, looks like our packet is ready. Yeah, Mr. Lagbana. So we are all set for the journey, and it will start soon. So here it is. Here is the paratha with curry, and there is the mineral water bottle I forgot to take. So we are ready for the journey here. So just beside this shop, there is a big mango garden here, and it is so beautiful. The nature is so soothing here. It looks also fantastic. And these are the natural habitats of birds. Lot of birds living here. There, I can already hear their call. And just beside this, there is this lake. In Bengali, we call this Ashokhura Kriti Hod. This is Oxbow Lake. এখানে কিছু করতে হবে এন্ট্রি করতে হবে আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে হিয়ার ইট ইজ উই আর অন আওয়ার ওয়ে টু দ্য ঘাট টু দ্য ডক ইউ ক্যান সে অ্যান্ড ফ্রম দেয়ার উইল রাইড দ্যাট বোট সো আওয়ার বোটম্যান ইজ দেয়ার হি উইল অ্যান্ড হি ইজ অলসো গাইড অ্যাট দ্য সেম টাইম হি উইল অলসো গিভ আস এ ট্যুর অ্যান্ড টেল আস অ্যাবাউট দ্য বার্ডস অ্যাবাউট দ্য মাইগ্রেটরি বার্ডস দ্যাট আর অ্যাভেলেবল হিয়ার রাইট নাও আস্তে আস্তে আমি আগে উঠ Dada. Yes. So here it is. Here we are ready. We have already started seeing a lot of birds. And there is purple swamp hen that I can see. And there are a lot of laser whistling ducks. Yeah. Haan, ebong dekh beshi gobhirota o noy. Wow. They are flying away. You have to be extremely careful here, and you have to speak softly because you know, otherwise they will fly away. Wow, really feels like we have come to a magical place. Yeah, what a burnt swallow, na ki edike? Swallow, and there is the swallow bird. Wow. And these are cotton pygmies. So this is how it looks. Here is our guide cum boatman. So tomar naam ki bhai?
Rahul Sk.
Okay. So I will also provide his phone number in the description. So he is really experienced guy. He is just telling me about all these birds that are available here right now. And I can feel it. He's extremely experienced one. And this is how we are going through the all these weeds and all those water plants. You can really see the water is not that deep. There are black-headed ibis. I don't know if the camera is doing justice to this situation, but I can clearly see all these birds. Wow, this is just heaven for bird photographers. And the local villagers also catch fishes here. You can see all these nets. This might be harmful for the birds, but the situation is getting better. Feels like we are stopped here, and there are
black-headed ibis. Two black-headed ibis are there. Wow.
I wish I had long lens. It looks fantastic.
This is really heaven, believe me. And I absolutely love birds. I love to watch them, I love to study them. And I don't have sufficient lens. I have only 18 to 55 mm lens, which is absolutely not sufficient for bird photography. But I am trying to take as much as shots with the habitation of the bird. Yeah. And this looks absolutely beautiful. Yeah. There are also a stork that flew by. Wow. And you can see the water is extremely clear here. Yeah. Extremely clear water. And these are the water plants that are here. Yeah. It is heaven, believe me. I'm really enjoying this place. And special thanks to our boatman, our guide. He's making this situation more beautiful. His expertise, his knowledge about the bird is absolutely incomparable. I'm loving it. Yeah. And this place is ideal for photographers. All those birds, they are in the swallow water, and if you stay in this boat, you can easily and you can very beautifully, very professionally capture them. I'm speaking softly because you know you cannot speak louder here, that will disturb all these birds. That's why I'm trying to speak softly as I can.
And another fishing net.
There is a bun swallow that is flying. Yeah, there is the bun swallow. Yeah, that bun swallow just sat on that stick. And there is a stock that is
open stock bill.
Okay. Open stock bill that is resting there.
Little grebe.
Wow. So did you see that? Little grebe just. Yeah, it is. I mean, it is absolutely a scene to remember. I'll never ever forget that. I think the camera captured that. That looks fantastic. And there is the little grebe that just flew by, splashing the water. Yeah, there was this kingfisher also. That looks fantastic. I wish I had a long lens. Yeah. Whenever I'm thinking about the short lens that I have in my DSLR, I am feeling sad. So I have to repeatedly encourage myself. Yeah. Feels like I have to buy a long lens. And this looks absolutely beautiful. I'll come to this place. The weather is also perfect for bird watching. It is not early morning now. Wind is blowing, which is making this place more comfortable. Wow. So this is how you will travel to this place if you ever come. And if you are a nature lover, if you want to spend some time quietly, or if you just want to study birds, or if you want to capture birds, there is no place better than this. There is a grebe and a lesser and a few lesser whistling ducks. I'm really sorry. I think they flew by after seeing me. And there is a grebe. Lot of grebes. Onek grebe ache bhai. Wow. And there is bun swallow just catching a worm. Wow. See bun swallow. And lot of grebes. Just check them. Lot of grebes. Wow. So this is basically an Oxbow lake. The main river, the Ganges, which I covered in my previous blog.
when I was traveling to Mayapur. You can check that in the description. So
the river Ganges is flowing by that side, and this place is meeting there. I will take him. And this lake is going to meet the Ganges there, probably at that side. We will also go there. And there is a place which is called the Amazon of India, or the Amazon of Purbasthali. The Purbasthali is the name of this place, and that place looks absolutely fantastic. And there is a local villager, a local man who is catching fish there with a small stick, and there is Borshi. I don't know the English of Borshi right now. There is a hook, yes, he is using a hook and a small stick, which in Bengali we call chip, a cane you can say. So using this he is catching fish. All these insects, they are good food for the birds, and this is the reason a lot of birds come here. It is calm and quiet and extremely peaceful and ideal habitat for them to stay. So I was never afraid of birds. So I can clearly remember I'm a boy from a village, extremely rural area. I'm from extremely rural area, you can say. Wow. Check this out, it looks heavenly. Yeah, it is so beautiful and so soothing. And there is a little grebe there, just dived into the water. Wow. Bhai, ek to aste aste ekhanta. And yeah, there's the little grebe that came out, yes, and again dived. It looks absolutely beautiful. And there are a lot of lambs. Oh, another grebe there. Wow, that was so close. That looks fantastic. And there is a kingfisher there at the top of that bamboo. You can hear the call of the swamp hen, I think. Yeah. Grebe ducks. And the grebe, they are calling again and again. And the flying style of little grebes are absolutely soothing to your eyes. They don't fly too high of the water. I'll just tell you about that. But there is a bronze winged jacana.
Sandpiper.
Wow, seems like it's dancing.
So as I was telling you, the flying style of grebes are absolutely fantastic. They don't fly too high of the water level, they just fly splashing the water, and they fly like that for so long, and it looks absolutely fantastic. I captured a few moments like that. Another villager who is on his journey to catch fish, I think. So these structures are prepared here. These are prepared to catch fish, because you know, when the people living here, when it is not this winter time, they usually catch fish for their livelihood. Yeah, look at the photo here. Wow. This looks absolutely beautiful. And he has a net, fishing net with him. You can see clearly. Operative, huh? In Bengali, we call this kochuri pana. So a lot of kochuri pana here, which is making this place absolutely special for birds. You know, birds stay here inside these bushes. They stay, they feel safe here. They spend time there, and this is the reason this place is becoming special for birds. A lot of migratory birds coming here. So good thing is that I have this binocular with me. This is an Olympus 1050 binocular. So it is extremely helpful. It is It is really heavy though, but it's helping me to watch these birds, to satiate my mind by watching them. Just look at him. He's really an expert. Wow. And this place is not too deep. It is shallow. Shallow water here. Not too deep. Feeling like I think I'll swim here. The water is too cold. You know? Crystal clear water. Yeah. Wow. Another. Purple moor hen. Swamp hen. Okay. And wow, there is a stock bill that I can see. Everything is just perfect. Sapa chen. Kichu have an anaconda nahi. So there are a lot of laser whistling ducks that I can see. There are jacanas. These are egret. Wow. Huh. But yeah, we are kind of sad to see. Look at this flower. This is really beautiful. Kochuri panar phool. So sometimes it's really sad to see a lot of plastic bottles here in the water. It's really disheartening to see. And yeah, the local authorities is trying to make all the people aware about this hidden gem. This place is also providing. Wow, jacana. Bacha. The babies of jacana. Wow. There are a lot of burnt swallows that I can see. Here is another one flying. And it's making this place really, 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 absolutely beautiful. So we are on our way to the main river, Ganges. This was the part of the river, as you already know, Oxbow Lake. It takes a lot of years, probably a couple of thousand years, to get prepared. And we are going to the main river. And we wish we'll be able to see osprey, because you know, osprey is really a bird to watch. So we are in search of osprey, but we're not sure if we will be able to find that. Check this out. Lot of kuchuri pana. Wow, it is so close. You can see this algae. I don't know the name of this algae. So if you know the name, please write it down in the comment section. I would love to know about them. Two local villagers, two local little boys, two local child, you can say, and they are having a great time there at the bank of this lake. And that is also a boat that is for one person, that is used for fishing. You can see that is made by tin, that is not made by wood. Tin, proper tin. Tai to tin diye toiri sei barir chhauni jete dai oi tin diye toiri. Wow. Check this out. You have to be extremely courageous to ride that one. And all the people are habituated with it because they are not doing this for a few hours. This is their life. This is what they do here. And there is another heron. Just look at this landscape. It is so beautiful here with these wildflowers. It looks absolutely fantastic. Here, look.
Wow, there is another heron. Look at this. There is a moor hen.
Nouka giye is ekta rasta toiri hoye geche jano mone hocche.
Check this out. This is just, it looks like a way on the water. It has become by all these boats, and there is a heron. He is feeding on something.
Pond heron.
Yeah, you can really feel he is extremely knowledgeable about birds. And he is here, he has been working here for so long. He is also a student, which is really good. I'm trying to encourage him to study more. And wow, I'm really happy to have him with me, believe me. So I'll also provide his contact details in the description. So you just come with him and you will feel absolutely blessed.
These lapwings.
There is one lapwing that just flew by. There's a lot of banana. It is, looks like a banana garden. So as I was telling you, pankori. Pankori English te ki bole hai?
Cormorant.
Greater cormorant ache ekhane boro gulo?
Na.
Nei na, choto choto gulo I royeche. So as I was telling you before, this structure is made by local villagers and they connect nets here. You can see this wire type. You can see this rope. They connect nets with this and the net comes to at this point, huh? Oh, okay. So there is another grif that just ate a fish. I missed the situation. Okay, so this structure is made by local villagers, as I was telling you before. And this is made for catching fish. And as I was telling you before, the landscape looks absolutely beautiful. Looks like you have come to the set of Hollywood. Looks like, yeah, it is. This is rural. This is real rural India. This is real rural Bengal. And there is a pied kingfisher that is all set to catch fish. Yeah, that will just dive. Yeah, just dived. Wow. I saw so many videos of a pied kingfisher catching fish. I just witnessed that moment today. That looks really fantastic. Wow. And you can see farming is being done just at the side of this lake. Mustard is being farmed. So there is a egret or heron, you can say, that is flying by. And they have used scarecrow there, you know. All these birds, they sometimes go to the field and destroy the crops, which is inevitable. That's why they use scarecrow there. You can see that there. And another, wow, look at the landscape. I'm really fascinated by the landscape of this place. It looks absolutely beautiful. Lot of plastic bottles there, which is making me sad. Sometimes they clean this place, but they might have missed them. Check this out, all these insects. And again, we are coming to a fishing point. So as I was telling you before, they connect nets from this bamboo to that bamboo, and the nets comes to that point. So using this, they can go up and down, and this is how the nets come up and down. And when it is drowned in the water, the fishes come on the top of it. And when they pull that out, all the fishes come here. And from there, they catch the fish. And this is a boat. And you can say there is a place to stay on the top of the boat. So feels like the fishermen who stay here, they spend night sometimes here. So we are gradually moving towards the main river, towards the Ganges. So eta nodiye dhuke gelam amra nodiye dhuke gechi. So we just changed district and we are in the Nodia district right now. So this lake is really big, Oxbow lake, as I told you before. We crossed the East Vardhaman and now we are in the Nadia district. And there
there is Mayapur, which is the spiritual capital of India, you can say.
Oh, acha. Eta ki pochard? Okay. There are a lot of migratory birds here. They're from Siberia. Wow, I can't believe it. This looks magical. Really, this looks magical. They are from Siberia. Wow. They are our guests. And we are taking, looks like we are taking great care of them. They are just enjoying this place, having a great time. We will make sure not to disturb them. Ekto dud diye jabo amra dekhbo etai chesta korbo bhalo kore. Okay, look at them lapwings. Wow, another lapwing is there. So I am full. Oshadharon lagche ei truck ei drishyo. So we will go to them, not too close, but we will enjoy them from far away. By not disturbing them, we'll try to enjoy their presence. Wow, just wow. They look so beautiful. Here is another structure which was built for fishing. The net is kept there. You can see the net also. A lot of kingfishers are hiding in these places, in these bushes. And they are our guest from Siberia. A really long way, couple of thousands miles away. Wow, thousands and thousands miles away. A lot of birds from Siberia. Wow.
So it's not a holiday, it's a regular weekday here. So not so many tourists are present today. So we're really enjoying this nature. Sometimes there are a lot of tourists which make this place less enjoyable, or yeah, that's what you can say. But today there is absolutely no tourist. We're the only one, feels like, at this site at least. So check them.
Wow,
red crested pochards. Male female sabi royeche mone hocche.
Lalta male
karon purushrai beshi sundor hoy ekhane. So in the animal world, the male are the most beautiful one. So the red crested pochard, you can see the beautiful ones, those with red beaks, they are the male. And other which looks less beautiful, they are females. So I'm trying to speak really softly here, because you know, I don't want to scare them. Yeah, they are having a great time. They are preening, eating, feeding on all those insects. So there is a water bottle here, and you can see the fishing net is connected to it. Yeah, which might be dangerous for birds. Bhai, eta ki mach dhorar jal ache. It's really sad to see. And that was a nylon rope there. It's really sad to see. And check this out, a lot of birds. Wow. I hope you can see them clearly. They look absolutely fantastic. And I'm going out of words. They look so beautiful. And a couple of hundred red crested pochards, both male and female, are here. And the water looks really shallow here. I don't know, might be deep, but the water widths there, they might be long or something like that. Wow, look at this. I'll try to show you some footage from the DSLR also. They look absolutely surreal. Really.
close to them, another one just flew by. It is kingfisher, na ki?
Northern slover.
Northern slover. Wow. That was.
Acha.
Jeta ude gelo. There was a northern slover. They just flew by. So we were not that close though. They were alert somehow, and they flew by. Wow, it was a sight to remember. Oh, is it? So there are also a lot of laser whistling ducks there. They are resting, so we don't want to disturb them either. They are flying. Some of them are flying there.
Bhai, thik ache. Ektu side diye gelo oshubidha nei.
And check this out, the group that just flew by, they are flying there. Wow. And there is also a really big egret. Wow, look at this. He looks wise and so beautiful. Wow. 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 Just only one word coming out of my mouth. Wow. The world is a really beautiful place. Wow, the nature is so soothing, so beautiful. And laser whistling ducks. And you can see all those cormorant. There is also a cormorant there. And that is mustard field there. You can see that looks absolutely beautiful. The mustard field just by the side of this lake. Wow, that looks so yellow and so fresh. You know, I hope you know the popular Hindi song from Dilwale Dulhaniya Le Jayenge, Tujhe Dekha To Ye Jana Sanam. So if you have not heard that song, go to YouTube after watching this video, obviously. Wow, that heron came here. Hi buddy. Sorry, I was soft. I was speaking softly. Don't think I disturb him. অসপ্রে তো এই জায়গাতেই থাকে,
এখানে আসে মানে খুব কম।
আচ্ছা, আমরা লাস্ট বার দেখেছিলাম তাহলে মনে হয় ওই সাইডটাতে, ওই গঙ্গার সাইডটাতেই দেখেছিলাম। হ্যাঁ, ওই দিকটাতে গঙ্গা আছে, আমাজনের পরে। অ্যান্ড ইউ ক্যান সি, আই থিঙ্ক ইউ ক্যান সি, সো আই ক্যান সি নাও ক্লিয়ারলি দ্য টেম্পল, দ্য বিগেস্ট হিন্দু টেম্পল হুইচ ইজ বিং বিল্ড অ্যাট মায়াপুর, দ্যাট ইজ সাম আউট ভিজিবল ফ্রম দিস প্লেস। সো হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ, আড়াল হয়ে গেল এখনই আর কি এইখানটাতে। উই আর অ্যাট দ্য এক্স্যাক্টলি অপোজিট সাইড অফ মায়াপুর। সো ইন মাই প্রিভিয়াস ব্লগ আই কভার্ড মায়াপুর। সো মায়াপুর ইজ দ্য বার্থ প্লেস অফ চৈতন্য মহাপ্রভু, অ্যান্ড দ্যাট ওয়াজ এ ট্রিপ টু রিমেম্বার। প্লিজ ভিজিট দ্যাট ব্লগ, প্লিজ ওয়াচ দ্যাট কেয়ারফুলি। আই হ্যাভ শেয়ার্ড মাই হোল এক্সপিরিয়েন্স ইন দ্যাট ব্লগ। হ্যাঁ, পার্পল হেরন, ওই যে ওইটা, ওকে। অ্যান্ড দেয়ার ইজ এ পার্পল হেরন দ্যাট ইজ সিটিং দেয়ার। এ লট অফ পার্পল মুর হেন্স অলসো দেয়ার প্রেজেন্ট।
we just turned our boat and we'll be heading towards the Ganges now. So we just witnessed the beauty of cotton pygmy goose. They're absolutely beautiful. And he also mentioned which is male and which are female. So we are really hungry now. So we are ready with our tiffin. But before that, let's sanitize our hands and start eating what we have. So here. It is the spiritual capital of India, you can say, which is just at the other side of the bank, which is you can see there. I can see that clearly now, but yeah, I think the camera is making justice of the scene. Yeah, the temple is under construction. It was said to be inaugurated in the year 2023, but I think it will not be possible due to the COVID situation. The work was stopped. Now the work is on full swing and it's almost ready, but not open yet. Hopefully it will be soon. So if you have not checked my previous vlog, I covered everything when I traveled to Mayapur. So I am requesting my brother to stay here, to stop here for a few minutes to complete our tiffin. After that we'll sail again. We are all ready with our food. This is just paratha, which I ate before, but now, and it is curry. We have brought it by plastic, but we'll make sure not to throw it in the water. You know, that will be extremely harmful for all these birds. So we'll just So this is for our brother. তুমি না অল্প না অল্প না কিচ্ছু ব্যাপার না তুমি নাও তো নিজের মতো করে খাও অল্পই দিয়েছি আছে অল্প অল্প করেই তিনজনে না and this is it, this is for us. So you can see we are almost at the middle of this lake and we are ready to eat our tiffin. So it's an experience to remember, no doubt. So we, three of us, we are ready with our paratha and cauliflower curry with
torkari ache to,
and there is also bhai torkari ache kintu jolo ache lagle bolbe jol tai rakhi. So I'll also eat it with mishtiale bhalo hoto ha bollin na tokhon. Wow. So our paratha getting cold now. So our paratha is cold now. The curry is kind of hot because you know it was kept in the direct sunlight, but we are sad to see the paratha is cold. Wow. But the taste is absolutely the same. It's really an experience to remember. I'll never ever forget this. Eating paratha. Paratha is one of my favorite food. So give me paratha and kochuri, I will need nothing. I will live like that. Just eating paratha and kochuri. So paratha, curry, and good thing is that I'm also not alone. This is what making me really, really, really happy. And so let's focus on eating now. We're gradually getting closer and closer to that place which is called the Amazon of India or Amazon of Purbasthali. So we are nearer. We are almost, look at this extremely narrow lake here. The lake is extremely narrow and we are on our way to the Amazon of Purbasthali. And there is another structure, another bamboo structure for fishing. So from this place the Amazon starts, you can see, and this artist is drawing pictures sitting here. Really beautiful place, really a place to remember. Look at this. This place is getting narrower. It is so narrow, and both these plants at the two sides, at the both sides of this river or this narrow lake. It looks absolutely beautiful here. The boat will pass by this narrow area, and it looks absolutely beautiful here. Wow. It looks fantastic. So we just came to the main river, which is Ganga, which is flowing at that side. Now we are returning from that place. Our brother was telling us to go to that side of the bank, that side of the river, but sadly we don't have much time left. That's why we are returning. And this place looks absolutely beautiful. No doubt it is called the Amazon of Bengal. It is so beautiful here. And here is one local villager, he's fishing. There are a lot of jacanas there. I think you can hear them now. So we are on our way back, and still lot of birds can be seen. There is a grebe. There are a lot of jacanas there. Yeah. Lesser whistling ducks. There are cormorants. Moorhen. Ducks. So we have just come closer to the land area. Here you can see a lot of egrets, glossy ibis, and there is also black-headed ibis. Yeah, they look absolutely fantastic. Really beautiful there. Our journey officially coming to an end. So it was a really nice experience, and I will come again. I was telling my brother that I will come again here, and now we will get off this boat. You can see a lot of boats are here. Everyone almost coming, as it is almost noon and the sun is shining brightly now. So most of them are coming, some of them are going there. Those who want to capture the osprey, they are going at that side of Amazon that I said to you before. But yeah, as I told you before, it was really a nice experience and I will come again. So hope you like this video. If you really like this video, give this video a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe so that we can never stop traveling together, never stop exploring together. So see you soon with a new video in the new episode. Bye bye for now.